We're going to look at k-means as an optimization problem. So remember when we talked about optimization, we worried about configurations. I think we called them inputs at the time, but I think it's going to be helpful to think of them as configurations here. There was a way of scoring configurations, and we were trying to find configurations that had high score. And for some of the algorithms, we needed a notion of a neighborhood so that we could move from configuration to configuration trying to improve.
Mm-hmm.
So in this setting, the configuration, the thing that we're optimizing over, is the partitions, the clusters. And we also have this kind of auxiliary variable of where the centers are for those clusters. And what we need now is a notion of scores. How do we score a particular clustering? So do you have any thoughts about what would be a better or worse clustering according to the kind of k-means algorithm?
Well, if I think about what you were saying earlier about what we were trying to do with creating these clusters, and I look at this notion of a center, so something pops in my head. So you would like to have centers or partitions that somehow are good representations of your data. And why does that matter? Because you said in the very beginning that we often think of unsupervised learning as compact representation. So if you want to have a compact representation, it would be nice if you don't throw anything away. So I'm going to say that a good score would be something that captures just how much error you introduce by representing these points as partitions, or in this case, as centers. Does that make sense?
Okay. Yeah, I guess that's a perfectly reasonable way to think of it. Another way to think of it is in terms of error, right? Yeah, which I guess is the same idea. Like if you think about the object as being represented by the center of its cluster,
mm-hmm.
then we want to know how far away from the center it is.
Right, and the farther away it is, the more error you have in representing it.
Right. So here's a concrete way of writing down what we think the scoring function could be. So we're going to say that the error, it's kind of the negative score, right? This is something that we want to minimize, even though generally we've been talking about optimization as maximizing. Here's something we want to minimize. That if you give me a particular way of clustering it and you define the centers based on, say, that cluster, what we're going to do is we're going to sum over all the objects the distance, the squared distance, actually, between the object and its center, right? So P of x is the cluster for x, and center sub that is the center for that cluster.
So that drives home the idea that we're talking about Euclidean distance here, because x would have to be in the same space as the centers are by definition. Okay.
Yeah. And I'm not sure exactly how we're going to define neighborhood, but one way to define neighborhood is that the neighborhood of a configuration, which is a P and a center, is the set of pairs where you keep the centers the same and you change the partitions, or you keep the partitions the same and you move the centers. So you're basically changing one of these at a time.
Oh, that's very clever, Michael.
Thanks.